is everyone doing today? Welcome back to UnlockNJHomes Live. Today we have a really, really special guest. You might remember him from when he performed Ricky Martin's hit single, She Bangs, from the third season of American Idol back in 2004. He has appeared on shows like Jimmy Kimmel, The Howard Stern Show, The Ellen DeGeneres Show, Dateline NBC, Arrested Development, and so much, so much more. He has performed in front of crowds all over the world. Ladies and gentlemen, please, please let me welcome Mr. William Hung. How's it going, brother?
Hey, I'm doing amazing. How about you?
I'm doing well. You know, I'm just trying to stay healthy during the pandemic, trying to stay busy.
Oh, of course, of course.
So how's it going with yourself? What you been up to?
Well, I am about to start my own talk show on a new live streaming platform called Livit, L-I-V-I-T. I recently signed a contract with them to be the contracted streamer. So that's where I'm going. Initially, I thought about like playing video games on stream, but I don't think that's the ideal platform for that because I thought about, you know, like other platforms like Twitch and whatnot. They don't have Mixer anymore. So, but I would say Twitch is also like really, really tough to break through right now. So yeah. And then for me, like since I enjoy talking, I enjoy meeting people. I think that new platform was a better fit for me.
Nice. Nice. So, tell us a little about, yourself. Where are you from?
For me, I am originally born in Hong Kong. And then I moved to Los Angeles with my parents. And then we've been living there for the last 20 years.
Nice, nice. You know, I know everybody on here that's watching right now is probably expecting this next question, I'm assuming, right?
Yeah, of
so,
course.
So, I know it's been about nearly 17 years, but what was it like performing in front of Paula, Randy, and Simon Cowell?
It was definitely one of the most nerve-wracking moments in my life. I'm still like looking back at it. It's like I couldn't find another moment where my feet were shaking, my arms were shaking, my heart was pounding. I definitely had some nervous moments in other performances and speaking opportunities and whatnot. But that was still the most nerve-wracking moment in my life. Just because I knew there was this potential for my audition to be viewed by millions of people.
Oh man, and it definitely did, huh?
Yeah.
So, I mean, you definitely were, you know, I was gonna ask you if you were nervous, but you definitely answered that.
Yeah.
I mean, since you answered that, I know you performed in front of the Golden State Warriors and everything. What was that like?
Well, I felt like that when I performed in front of like the basketball games, like Golden State Warriors or Hornets, New Orleans Hornets. It's oh, like, wow. It's not, yeah, I actually performed for Rockets as well. Houston Rockets back then.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah. So it's not as crazy, as the initial, performance because I had more experience. I was starting to get used to the crowds.
So, you know, I mean, you know, in this business of real estate, it's a lot of, you know, we have a lot of big dreams in this business and everything. That's the big thing about real estate. We, you know, especially with all these new glamour television shows, we just released a new television show called Million Dollar Beach House, which is just about realtors buying, you know, selling homes in the Hamptons for millions and millions and millions of dollars. So speaking of dreams, I got to ask you, how did it happen? How did you end up on American Idol?
Ooh, I would say that, I remember back in Berkeley, I was a struggling civil engineering student. So I just thought maybe it's time for me to try something new. Then one day I saw a poster for a school talent show. I figured, why not? There's nothing to lose. So I started watching and studying Ricky Martin's She Bangs music videos. I didn't have any expectations, but somehow I won. The grand prize was a DVD player.
Man, imagine that. A DVD player these days.
Well, back then it meant a lot. So
oh, yeah. 2004, it gave me
that, yeah. Yeah, so it gave me that confidence to audition for American Idol.
Wow. So Next thing you know, you got a call. You're standing on American Idol. What was your initial when Simon, Randy, and Paula reacted? What was your initial emotion? What did you feel inside initially?
I would say that it was more or less what I expected. Like I knew that Simon was always going to be the mean guy. but Randy is going is trying to be funny and cool, and then Paula is always a nice lady.
So, how has this business, you know, how did American Idol impact you as a person?
It changed my life forever. Like, I went from this average person, like average student, to overnight celebrity. All of a sudden, everybody knows who I am. But the way they know me is also very fascinating, because whenever I take a walk in public, you know, have my meals, go shopping, or do wherever else I want to do in my life, the way that people recognize me is like, wait a minute, aren't you that American Idol guy? Aren't you that She Bangs guy?
Well, that did some amazing things for you, right? I saw that you signed like a 20, you know, from American Idol, you signed like a $25,000 contract with Koch Records. You released a couple of albums.
Yep.
Wow. What was that like? What was it like recording music?
It was definitely a once in a lifetime experience, but I would say this, it's not what I expected either, because like they were, the record company was trying to rush out the album before the American Idol could declare the winner, in May. Mm. So for that season, it was Fantasia, but my album came out maybe February or March, you know, they were like absolutely rushing it.
Hey, we apparently one of our guests has played against you, played poker against you in Vegas.
Oh yeah, that's I also enjoy playing poker, so yeah, that's very very possible that we played together before.
nice. So what have you been doing ever since?
Well, I've been traveling and performing all over the world for about 4 years, since 2004, but then my entertainment career slowed down. And then I thought maybe I can go back and finish school, get a stable job, save and invest my money, and that's good. Life is good, right? That's it. But then I feel like I'm missing something in my life. It's like I feel that I'm meant to serve a bigger purpose than hiding behind my cubicles. So that's why I finally chose to quit my job early January this year. And I became a full-time professional poker player.
Wow. So what exactly were you doing? Like, what kind of job were you doing?
I was working for the government. I worked 2 years for the sheriff's department and then 6 years for the public health department.
Oh man, I can only imagine what that's like, going to work every day. How many times did they ask you to perform?
Only in the beginning. Like, oh my God, can I have a picture of you? Can you sign an autograph of my daughter? Yeah. So it's in the beginning. And then once that's over, it's back to normal work day.
Okay. But then whenever you go to other public places, then it's all over again, isn't it?
Yeah. It's even I remember one of my former supervisors, like, you know, she said, like, try not to cause a scene, you know. But it's kind of funny when she said it.
I saw that was very difficult for you, because when I was reading or saw online that you were aspiring to be a math teacher.
Yeah, I tried that as well, yes.
And, you know, the whole American Idol thing was just kind of working against you with that. I saw that you had a little song that you made for math.
And right. That's right. Teaching people about like positive and negative numbers.
That's amazing. That's hilarious. I can't believe they didn't want to keep you after that. That's like, this is a great way to keep people motivated.
Yeah. Maybe they were having too much fun.
Hey, that's not a bad thing, right? You learn the most when you're having fun, right?
Right. Yeah.
So, I know for a fact that, you know, there was a lot of, you know, obviously there was a lot of positive, you know, positive criticism when you were on American Idol, and obviously with any kind of fame, there's, you know, there's a lot of negative criticism as well.
For sure.
How were you able to take all of that negative criticism and then just turn it to positive energy and just you know, just become such a, you know, motivate people and everything as well?
I would say that the most important thing is to come from a place of standing strong. Like it's almost like the internal belief. I'm here to share the love and respect for other people. The most recent example that I finally came out of my shell to talk about is how Jimmy Rogan Jim Rogan, he mentioned that I was mentally challenged on his show, and then Jimmy O Yang added fuel to the fire, saying that I'm setting back Asians 10 years in the entertainment industry. So the way I chose to handle it is I just address the issue without attacking them back in a rude way. Like, I'm not trying to put down other people. You know, that's never a good way to go about it. So the response that I posted recently on social media, and you know, it'll be the same response when I do other interviews, is that, like, you know, for the part about being mentally challenged, well, look at the impact that I'm making in the world. Look, you know, my first album, Inspiration, was the number one independent album on billboards. I inspired 250,000 people to keep chasing their dreams.
100%. I mean, regardless of you being the best singer or not the best singer at all, you definitely had the confidence to do it, you know, and you got paid a lot of money to do it at the same time, you know. And, you know, I mean, if anybody's going to say anything, you know, there's nothing negative about, you know, being able to do, you know, finding an opportunity and capitalizing on an opportunity. There was an opportunity for you to jump on, and you took advantage of it and created a platform out of it. So, I mean, if anything, I got to say kudos to you on that. Congratulations. You know, the fact that they're even talking about making a movie about you is just incredible. You know, I mean, for you to be able to tell your side of the story through whatever it is, it's just, you know, just, you know, nobody could just ever imagine that for their lives and everything. And you're living that dream.
Yeah, I agree. It's definitely, I would say my primary motivation to keep pushing forward, against the negative criticism is not money. It's about, like, what you just said right there. It's pure gold. What you just said right there, sharing your side of the story. You know, like for me, I just wanted to try something new as a college kid. You know, that's all it is. I have a problem with people like trying to exaggerate what that means. Like, you know, oh my God, William Hung portraying Asian stereotypes. I mean, there wasn't even an article back then saying like how I committed suicide due to heroin overdose. It's like, what?
Sheesh.
Yeah.
I do remember all the stories, actually, because I remember, you know what it was? It was 2004 when you blew up. I think you blew up around the same time as Jin. So, like, it was completely on the opposite side, because I don't know if you remember that, but Jin was the Chinese rapper and everything.
And
everything. And then you were on the other side of it doing doing what you were doing specifically with the regard thing.
Right.
But regardless of it, is that whether or not the attention that we got at that particular point, I think Asians in general just got a lot more attention at that time, you know, and whether it's negative or positive, we got attention that we never have gotten at that point.
Yeah. And in terms of like Jimmy's comment, like setting back Asians, I strongly disagree. Like what you mentioned, right? Because more Asians are willing to put themselves out there to showcase their talent after my American Idol audition. And as a result of that, now we are able to be ourselves. You know, there are so many successful Asian singers, Asian gamers, Asian magicians, Asian dancers. No, this is great.
Yeah, we get to fall into every category now in regards to entertaining. You know, we're in movies now. Like we're doing great things now. Television shows where we're literally star cat. You know, some of the star roles of the movies. We got that Shang-Chi movie coming out from Marvel, coming out in year or whatever it is.
Yeah.
It's a lot of great stuff happening in our community, man.
Right.
Great, great stuff. So in real estate, I can tell you, we deal with a lot of, you know, a lot of rejections, and statistically, out of all new agents, after the first 5 years, 87% quit, which means only 13% of real estate agents actually survived this business. And And in reality is most realtors don't quit because they're not making enough money. You know, just like what Tom Berrywood said, they don't quit because they're making too much money. They quit because they're not making enough money. You know, and
it's hard. Yeah.
It's hard. You know, it is hard dealing with the downtime, dealing with the rejections, not having a salary, you know, and there's a lot of rejections in this business and everything. Like,
oh, I agree.
Specifically, you've dealt with a lot of objections in your life.
Of course.
What would your advice be to newer agents that lack confidence? And, you know, what would you say to those who are holding themselves back due to the lack of confidence?
Wow. I could tell you that as an entertainer, like that's still like, you know, lighting it up in the media it hasn't been easy. You know, my 16 year journey has been ups and downs. Yeah. Linda says 4-7 times, get up 8. I agree. I had to reinvent myself like 4 to 5 different times. Like I started off taking the what's given to me. You know, you work with what's given to you. Like I was given a platform to sing and perform everywhere. It was wonderful, right? A dream life. But that didn't last forever. So I learned how to save and invest my money. And then eventually I evolved into, you know, being a motivational speaker. And then now I'm doing a talk show for a new life platform. You know, like it's all about evolving and finding a way to make things work for you. In real estate, I am not an expert in real estate, but I have friends that are pretty good at it. So I would say it's like, you know, it's also finding your what works for you, what you enjoy doing. Like, you know, maybe you help people being first time homeowners. Maybe you learn how to flip houses. Maybe you learn how to do wholesale. You know, like there are many possibilities. But the most important thing is that I would say it's like you have to look at it as a long game. There's no overnight success, right? It's very hard to get that nowadays. Like for me, I was very fortunate. I'm very grateful that I got that overnight celebrity, overnight success. But I know that when I try out, you know, these new platforms, that's not the case. You know, I had to build from scratch, not from scratch, but somewhat from scratch, right? I had to build these new connections, make these new relationships, learn everything about this new platform. So the same thing for you.
Yeah, 100%. That's how it's been for me as well. You know, I grew up in a town where I'm literally the 1% of all Asian Americans in my town. And, you know, just coming up in this business itself, you know, I didn't, you know, when I got into real estate, you know, I knew the people I grew up with. I knew the parents. I knew this and that. But the thing is, I didn't really know people to this extent. Like, they knew me as a person that grew up in town, but they didn't know me as what I am as a real estate agent. So,
yeah,
like you said, you know, right. You know, I had to reinvent myself in so many ways. You know,
Prior
to this, I was working full time in New York City at T-Mobile on 46 and 6. And I was working basically 5 days a week traveling
to
New York from New Jersey.
Wow.
Ooh, like three hour transitions, like
That's
three
crazy.
Hours every single day. It was a nightmare.
Yeah.
So I was like, I couldn't take this anymore. I had to reinvent myself. I didn't want to be the guy to sell cell phones for the rest of my life, for sure. I had to do something much different. And, you know, I created UnlockNJHomes, which is my, you know, the brand specifically to create diversity, to allow people to have, you know, a bigger platform to stand on. I want to create someone where, you know, a brand where someone's not trying to build a Christopher Chin group, the team. I want them to create and feel like, you know, have the freedom to be able to create that leverage themselves and be able to build
their own
brand. That's the ultimate thing, you know, reinventing this whole entire business and just stepping out of our comfort zone, you know, because
I agree.
Like Linda just said, with me, you know, I grew up when I was a kid, they used to, you know, I grew up listening to hip hop. People used to tell me, oh, you shouldn't be listening to hip hop because you're this, you know, because you're Asian. You shouldn't be listening to this stuff. This is not your type of music, blah, 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 blah.
I hear that
all the time when I was a kid. And they're like, You probably can relate where a lot of people told you you couldn't be somewhere, you shouldn't be somewhere because you are this way. But then meanwhile, the people that are telling you that aren't moving any further themselves.
Yeah, that's a good point. Because there are many people that you know feel that the odds are stacked against me. Like I don't really have a legitimate selling point. You know, it's like I don't have the best singing talent. I don't have the best dancing talent. It's like what's your selling point? but I feel like you know, I just being me. Maybe my selling point is not any of those things. Maybe my selling point is just, you know, the brand, what I represent over the years.
Resiliency, huh?
Yeah, recite. Right.
It's all about resiliency, because that's what it is. You know, I don't think there's greatness without adversity, by far. You know, if you don't know what it feels like to fall down, you're never going to know how it feels like to get up, you know. And, you know, the reality of it is, you know, I've taken step backs in my life, you know, even as I've been in this business, I had to take certain steps back. You know, I had team members, I've lost team members, I've had great deals, I've lost great deals.
Right.
You know? But at the same time, I've always felt that the moments that you take a step back are the reasons or the opportunities for you to take thousands of steps forward, you know.
Yeah, right.
Because you've been, you know, if you take one step back, you've already been to that extra step. Why not study that moment and try to figure out how to take another couple of steps ahead? You know,
and that's
the process of growth, you know. Without diversity, how do you learn that? You know,
I agree.
And otherwise, everyone's just constantly moving in the same beat if there's no diversity. And
there's
no growth.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
I saw that you've been a keynote speaker for a lot of ARI events lately and TED Talks and everything. So I know you mentioned that you have a lot of friends in real estate. Are you involved in real estate at all these days?
I would say that I'm educating myself on it. I'm not spending a lot of time into it, but my parents and I own 3 condos in the Los Angeles area. Right now I'm not looking to like make more investments for now, because I just talked to my financial advisor recently. She said that what I've been doing is pretty good. You know, I have some in real estate. I have a little bit of, you know, cash value, life insurance. I got my hand into my retirement account in stocks. You know, I'm generating like multiple streams of income from personal shout outs and my new business. So, yeah, you know, so she says probably shouldn't make any big moves right now, but maybe she told me to look at it again within the next 6 months. But in the meantime, I'm definitely always open to like new possibilities, because before I, and the reason I'm more open to it now compared to before, because before I was actually like maybe I was close-minded about real estate. I was like, you know, like, I don't have that much money to play around, like, you know, because you know, real estate, I mean, even though I am just 101, like beginner, but you know, I know how to beat Monopoly. I know how to beat cash flow. So what I learned from that is like, you know, you do need like, you know, a nice chunk of money to do like down payments, right? You need the time to actually work towards a real estate license. So things like that, right? So it's not an excuse, but it's not like, okay, do I want to spend my time there and now compared to maybe a little bit farther down the road?
Trust me, I get it. There's only so much time during the day for us to allocate to what we need to get done and everything. So it's a lot, you know. Real estate, anytime you're investing in real estate, it takes a lot of time, because you have to be on point. You have to manage all the people that's running the real estate. You got to make
sure. Exactly.
I mean, given the fact that you own a couple of condos right now, you know, it's probably a lot of work on you on top of everything that you already have to do already.
Well, the good news is that, you know, like my parents and I just dedicate to an agent to take care of it for us. Because we really don't want to manage day to day. Yeah.
Got a fan.
Yes.
We're about to get one of those out of you when we're done with this.
Yeah, sure. All right.
So what's new on the horizons? I know you mentioned the streaming platform.
Yes.
A lot happening for you. I know it's exciting times for you these days.
Yeah, that's definitely a really cool mission that I'm working towards. You know, it's just like anything else in life. Like when you start something new, it's like that's never going to be your main source of income. But I'm very glad that I chose something that's more mission driven, that adds value to other people. So the reason my talk show idea on Live It Has Legs is because there's nothing like that yet on the platform. And what I'm doing is I'm giving the unsung heroes in the platform and other new streamers a voice. That's my overall mission.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
Yeah,
I really appreciate what you're trying to do and what you're trying to accomplish. You know, despite all the negative criticism, like you mentioned before, the Joe Rogan podcast and what Jimmy Yang was saying and all the stuff, like, you know, you work really, really hard. There's no question about that. I saw your TED Talks. I saw your interviews. It's a lot of energy that you got to allocate and the time that you got to put towards that. And on top of that, you're putting you're driving to multiple different ventures and everything on top of what you're trying to do.
Yeah, that's why I try not to take too much at any one time. Really, realistically, I'm really only taking on one major project at a time. And so that way I'm not going crazy, right?
How are you faring with the stock market these days?
I'm not an expert in stock market either. So what I did, I don't mind sharing this with the listeners here. I put my money into a automated investment platform called Betterment. So there's a couple of legitimate ones. Betterment is one of them. Wealthfront will be another one. So yeah, you know, like I just want to make sure my retirement money is growing instead of shrinking.
That's what it's all about, you know, because we got to just keep on having multiple streams of revenue. And there's a lot of unpredictability with everything happening. We don't know how the world's going to be after the elections.
Oh, who knows?
Oh, man. Not to talk politics or anything like that, but who knows, you know, like we don't know how the world's going to be once November passes by. So,
yeah, but one thing's for sure, because, you know, the reason I'm really I'm keeping a closer eye now on real estate is because, you know, I realized how much money I'm giving up to Uncle Sam, by not having, you know, more money in my assets. Yeah, and that's a lesson I learned. You know, wait a minute, because one of the most common misconceptions is like you know what? Let's live this debt free life. You know, like let's don't have any debt. But that's not how I look at it.
No, 100%. I think I was watching Graham Stephan and everything. His portfolio is all about creating the debt and leveraging the debt. You know,
yeah.
How you make money these days, you know, the idea is with rates being the way it is right now, rates are all time low, 2.8,
right. Exactly.
2.5.
Yeah.
You know, if you're able to purchase in normal circumstances where rates were around 5 to 6, you know, people
right.
to purchase at 2.8, get a rate lock at 2.8 and purchase a price, rent out that unit, you know, a couple of years from now at that 5. And automatically you're just going to be making money at that point. So why not the debt at that point? Because your income is going to overcome the debt regardless anyways.
Yeah.
So I get it. I get it 100%. Diversifying your portfolio is very, very important these days for sure.
Yeah.
So, you know, I really appreciate having you on here today, man. This is absolutely incredible, man. This is a lot of fun. This is a complete honor to have you. I was really excited about this, so I'm pretty sure, you know, this is going to definitely be blasting all over YouTube and Facebook, so everyone's going to get to see this amazing interview that we had today. I got to ask you, man. I know everybody's asking.
Of course.
You give it to us one time, man. The she bangs, please.
All right, sure. No problem. She bangs, oh, baby. When she moves, I go crazy because she looks like a flower, but she stings like a bee, like every girl in history.
Thank you so much, William. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in today. If you guys have any other questions for William at all, please, 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 please just drop it in the inbox. We'll definitely get an answer for you. It was an absolute pleasure, brother.
No problem.
Thank you so much, guys. Have a good one.